Respected dignitaries and member of Indian Juristic Association of Japan,
good evening
and welcome to the first annual IJAJ opening dinner. It's both an honor and privilege to stand before you today and welcome to this community His Excellency Shri Sujan Ji Chunoy, Ambassador of Republic of India to Japan. I request the members of the audience to join me in offering a warm welcome to our most distinguished guest of this evening. Ambassador Shri Chunoy Sahab has been recently appointed to be the face of the Indian community in Japan, joining us on 3rd December 2015. He most recently served as the ambassador to Mexico and High Commissioner to Belize. And he continues his 35 years of representing our country with the Foreign Service, Indian Foreign Service, since joining in 1981. Our ambassador spent some time over 38 years ago in 1978 as an MBA exchange student program at the Otemon Gakuin University in Osaka. At the time, telling a Yomiuri Shimbun interviewer that he was his dream to come back to Japan someday as a diplomat. So it is a great joy for us to be able to welcome him back to this country after so many years. On that note, I hope we will be able to have an enjoyable evening. And with these words, once again, I offer a hearty welcome to you all. And please join me in honoring the presence of our chief guest tonight, our Ambassador Shri Sujan R. Chunoy Sahab.
Thank you very much. Now I request the President of IJAJ Group, Mr. Jatin Patel, to offer our gratitude to Mr. Chunoy. Please. We will request Mr. Chunoy to please, if he can address, come over here.
Members of the Indian Jewelers Association of Japan, and I cannot say ladies and gentlemen, but you are all gentlemen, down to the last man. And I must begin by congratulating the Indian Jewelers Association of Japan, because you have tonight organized this very beautiful function for me to welcome me in, and I should call it flawless. Use your own terminology. You have proved yourselves very worthy gentlemen on account of all the four C's, whether it is cut, clarity, color, or character. And when I came in to the welcoming tunes of Tum Bin Jaun Kaha, Ye Duniya Mein Aaya Hoon. It's true that today one cannot say that we go anywhere in the world without encountering the dynamic Indian community. There are 30 million people of Indian origin today settled all over the world. And each one of them as is each one of you, is a true ambassador of India. This is a community of overseas Indians, and this is especially true of the Jewelers Association in Japan, that you punch far above your weight, that you remain so strongly committed to your Matrubhumi, which is India, and you remain equally committed to your what you call Karma Bhumi, which is Japan, and that the debt of gratitude that you feel towards both is reflected in your commitment to both countries, especially in times of need. And I want to congratulate you on behalf of the Government of India, on behalf of the Embassy, for the very, very good humanitarian work that you undertook in Fukushima after the crisis developed in this country. Congratulate you for the work that you did in Uttarakhand, in Nepal, as elsewhere. And I think that is what brings out the true spirit in which Indians are traditionally brought up. This whole concept of regarding humanity as one, this concept of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, a concept in which we do our dharma, and our dharma and our karma may be about here and now, about making money, about being prosperous, but we do not forget those in need. We do not forget the spiritual values on which we have been brought up in our great culture. This is part of our DNA, to help others with compassion, to accept and tolerate others, to deal with disasters with fortitude, to reach out to others. This is something which Indians do not have to be taught in the vastness of our composite culture. We in India have traditionally been taught the values of unity in diversity. We belong to a civilization that stretches back into the distant mists of time, if I can put it that way. It stretches back thousands of years. It is a civilization which gave rise to people like Gautam Buddha, Mahavir. Mahavir was the first one to give the values of love, peace, truth, non-violence, compassion to the world. 100 years later in India, and that itself was 2,500 years ago, Buddha picked up these values too and refined them in his own way. Bringing to the world of that time the strong values and culture of India through the medium of Buddhism, supported by an even more ancient tradition of Jainism in India, which propounded the same values. In fact, the fountainhead was, in my view, as a student of Indian history, Mahavir and Jainism that gave rise to these values. These spread to East Asia. They spread to China. They spread to Japan. Some of it coming directly, some of it coming through China. And it is that tradition in which we have conquered even those that sought to conquer us. That tradition in which we assimilated even those that came with swords to make them true Indians at heart, such that they lost their own identities, they lost the anger in their hearts, they adopted the Indian way, and resulted in this very beautiful culture that we call our own. And as we move through the centuries, we have seen how great religions in India have developed, each feeding off the other, interacting with the other, and giving rise to our beautiful diversity. All the world's great religions are to be found in India. And there is a very Indian ethos to each one of them. As soon as you step out of India, some of them become a little unrecognizable. But in the Indian context, they are all like beautiful flowers in a single bouquet. And we are proud of this kind of diversity that we bring to our culture. Diversity of language, religion, of traditions, of cuisine, at the end of which we still remain very Indian. But as they say, you can take Indians out of India, you can take 30 million Indians out of India, but you cannot take India out of even one of them. So I am not surprised that I came into the welcome of that Tum bin jahan kahan. Without you, hum kahan jayenge? And it also reminds me when I say that you cannot take India out of not even one Indian. That you say that mera juta hai Japani, patloon hai Englishtani, sar pe lal topi Rusi, phir bhi dil hai Hindustani. I want to congratulate you tonight once again for turning up in such large numbers to greet me and my colleagues, to accord us such a warm welcome. You represent the cream, so to speak, of the Indian representation in Japan. Your presence is an old one. You have worked hard to build bridges of friendship and mutual understanding between our two countries. You have conducted your business in honorable ways. You have brought to the people of Japan some of the finest aspects of our beauty and craftsmanship through gems, jewels, diamonds. These are also areas in which India excels. Jewelry, for instance, is a very important component of India's exports. It is an aspect of India's economy that is in great demand all over the world. Our craftsmanship, our ability to cut even the smallest of diamonds, our ability to polish even the smallest of stones that come from various parts of the world. We have created a niche for ourselves through our ability, through our craftsmanship. And this is what comprises a very important segment of our trade relations, our exports to other countries. It is recognized as such by the government of India as well. Today you are operating in a Japan that looks upon India as a very, very friendly neighbor, so to speak, because in this globalized age we are neighbors. We are all neighbors, no matter what part of the world we are in today. It's just the click of a mouse that takes you across today. I'm sure you do a lot of your business with the click of a mouse. In this digital age, therefore, the distance of the tyranny of distance of the past, the oceans that divided us, the geographical territories that divided us, no longer exist. So we are near neighbors, India and Japan. And today we are near neighbors based on a foundation that is very firm, a foundation in which our dynamic government led by Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji and Prime Minister Shinzo Abe in Japan have a very close and personal relationship. They have a bond between them, a bond that is shared by the people of India and Japan on both sides. There is great consensus in Japan on developing friendly relations, cooperative relations, deeper economic ties with India. And similarly, there is a consensus in India across the political spectrum on developing close, friendly, cooperative relations with Japan. Japan today sees India as a great platform, a growing platform, a platform growing in importance and scope for its own economic activity around the world. We have today projected to the world that India offers something that no other country offers. A very large domestic market, a huge population, a youthful population, that is human resources, a full 50% of our population being below the age of 25, and above all, apart from the demographic dividend, we also offer to investors our democracy, our rule of law, our openness, our transparency. And Japanese companies are beginning to look at India as a very favorable destination for manufacturing, for taking their service sector out to India as well. Their technologies, which are safe in our hands, much safer than they might be elsewhere in terms of IPR and other issues. And we recently had the most successful visit of Prime Minister Abe to India. We signed some far-reaching agreements with Japan on the Shinkansen, on cooperation in the peaceful uses of nuclear energy. Our relations are growing. They are multifaceted, multidimensional today. And it is in this very positive environment that you today are representing your business in Japan, or I, for that matter, am representing the government of India in Japan. Let us therefore join hands to work together to take this relationship to even greater heights. I and my colleagues in the embassy stand ready to work very closely with each one of you, with your office bearers, with you not only at the professional level in terms of promoting your business, but also at the personal level, should you have any difficulties of a personal nature, to resolve all these issues. So with these few words, please allow me to once again profusely thank you, not only on my own behalf, but on behalf of the Embassy of India and my colleagues who are represented here this evening. A very big thank you to you for organizing this warm welcome.